singing and laughing. They don't even know what I'm going through. Is it really there for the asking? This love that they say in store, that will hold in my face. But I really need you to make a way for me. Outside it looks like it's going fine, but you don't really know what my story is. I can't really handle what's on my mind, but I know there's someone who is strong when all my strength is gone. Lord, can you tell me what's going on? It will be over. Soon it will be over. Trouble ain't gonna last forever. Trouble ain't gonna last. Soon it'll be over. Soon it'll be over. Yeah, trouble ain't gonna last forever.
Don't you know, honey, today is the big day.
The big day?
Yes, Henry told me that today he was meeting with his boss, honey, and I know this is it. Oh, yeah. He gonna get that big promotion. You know, he done put in all those hours down there on that job. Yeah, and he deserves it. And if you had any sense, girl, you be dancing and singing too.
Come on now, why should I be dancing and carrying on? Now, you know he barely let me move in here when I got kicked out of my apartment last week. Remember that?
Yeah,
remember that?
Yeah, yeah, but see, what you need to remember is that he did do it.
Oh.
You know, he always felt sorry for you when he saw you sitting out there on that sidewalk with all of your stuff.
You know they was wrong for that. I was gonna get them their money. I just needed a little more time.
Uh-huh, you got plenty of that, didn't you? But see, the good news is, sis, you got a good job now.
That's right, that's
so
right.
You can afford you a good place. And you know, you need to be getting up out of here real soon. Did you hear me, sis? Real soon. Yeah.
I hear you, girl, I hear you. Now, I do appreciate y'all taking a sister in when she was down, though.
You know what's wrong right now?
At the time, did I tell you that I found a place that would be perfect for me?
What?
I'm going to see about it today, girl, look. It's right down the street, so I can come and bother you and Henry whenever I need. Girl, it's in my price range. I'm gonna get there.
Okay.
I feel it.
Okay, get it, girl.
I'm gonna get my stuff, and I'm gonna be on my way.
Okay, hey, fix that, dude. Get that thing, you know.
Hey, don't move in my neighborhood. Don't make me stand the ground. Good morning, baby.
Good morning, Henry.
Hey, I ain't got time. I gotta go.
Wait a minute.
Baby,
your big moment.
This is it.
I'm getting ready. All right.
You know what we're gonna do?
What we're gonna do, girl?
No,
girl.
We're
doing the dance.
Girl. Oh, Henry, you all right? Ain't got time to worry about that. I gotta get on out of here.
Okay, what about your breakfast? What about
baby?
Breakfast?
I don't have time. And look, this is it.
That's what I see.
Oh, baby, all my hard work.
Yeah.
All them late nights is about to pay off. I'm gonna get this promotion.
Baby. All right, baby.
All right, I gotta go.
Yes! This is it. And he deserves it. He done worked hard all these years down there at that office. I'm so excited for him. I gotta get this sister out here. Sheila! Girl, you got to go too. Yeah?
You got to go.
Girl, I'm
going to find me a place and I'll be out of here as soon as I can find one. Trust me. Now, you know Henry get on my nerves anyway.
Man, you're getting all snippy. You done forgot about option number two.
And what's option number two?
You could have moved in with your mama. Yeah.
Girl, now I would have rather stay outside on that sidewalk with my lamp in my hand than move in with your crazy mama.
She your mama.
Dog, I'm playing.
All right,
girl, I gotta get
you better get on out of here, girl.
Be careful.
Go get him, go get him. Woo, this is gonna be a great day. Woo, I can't wait. I just can't wait. It's so exciting. I'm excited. Oh, oh. What? Well, if it ain't Bubba and his rusty little sidekick Meatball. What y'all doing out here this early in the morning?
Hey, Miss Esther, is he here?
Ooh, you know, Henry, is he here?
Now, y'all know when we're going to work, that's the same place y'all need to be.
Well, we stopped by to talk to you by surprising Henry.
Surprising him?
Yeah, surprising.
Wait a minute, I got things to do this morning. What y'all talking about surprising Henry?
Well, Henry always talking about this big old promotion he's up for. And me and Meatball and some of the other fellas thought it was a good idea just to throw him a little surprise party.
Yeah, you know, celebrate that big promotion and all.
Uh-huh, well, you know, y'all just a little bit ahead of the gun. He gotta get the promotion first.
Oh, you know we gonna get it. Yeah. He always down at that office putting him out. He gonna get that big promotion now.
You think?
I know.
Yeah! See, he don't even come with me and Meatball and some other fellas no more. Play poker.
So don't.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I'ma listen to you. What y'all talking about?
See? Alright, Miss Ethel. See, you're gonna love this.
Yeah, you're gonna love it around.
You know what? See, we're gonna rent this place out.
We can't. We ain't got the money for it. So we just gonna do it here.
Here?
Yeah.
See, then I'ma get this pole. And get them.
Ooh, wait a minute now. I know you're not talking about getting no stripper pole for my Henry.
Oh, no, Miss Stanley. Oh, no, Miss Stanley. See, I'm going to get the pole, put a flag on it, say congratulations, Henry, on your big promotion.
Really? No. He said earlier that we're going to get this pole and we're going to call a cinnamon, going to make him rain. You know, we're going
to. What? I know. Y'all. Hey. Cut that mess out in my house. See Jesus looking at y'all?
Can we continue?
Yeah, please, go on.
And then, we was all gonna hide out.
Hide?
And before he came in, we was gonna come out and say surprise!
Now, wait a minute. Don't y'all know that's what everybody does at a surprise party?
See? We never done it before!
Lord, have mercy. Take a bubble and a meat. Henry, what are you doing here? You scared the life out of me. What you doing back home so soon?
Oh, I know what he's doing home. You know, when you get them big promotions and all, just come home anytime you want. Do as you see fit. Ain't that right, Henry?
Now, see, Henry, I believe a congratulations in order, Henry, sir. Cut it out, man! What are y'all doing here for anyway? Don't tell me word done got out already.
No, Henry, they just came over here to wish you congratulations, that's all.
Yeah, Henry, it's like one of us come up, we all come up.
Yeah.
And see, Henry, man, if I was in your shoes, I'd be strutting my stuff all around this place.
Look, man, if you was in my shoes, you would be strutting your stuff nowhere, because you'd be fired. Fire!
Henry, what are you talking about, fire?
What do you mean, fire, baby? Cut loose, let go, downsize, turn up.
Henry!
I went down there. Man, I went down there, thought I was going to give me a job. I was all dressed looking good. Go down to get my job. And they gave my job to somebody else.
No,
they gave it to somebody else and then decided they didn't need me no more.
Coming up.
Yeah!
You're the next big thing.
Mm.
All of a sudden,
oh,
bam! Bam!
Wait,
bam!
Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam! Bam!
feet. Yeah. We sorry about that, Johnson.
No, you don't go on my A-track.
You know, we always be in your corner.
Look out of here.
You gotta go?
Yes, you got to.
Get him out of here. You're not my A-track.
See, that's real. Have you talk, my brother. See? Now, woo. No, we your boys. We always got your back. Now, hey, you know it? See, I'm gonna check around, make a few phone calls, and I get back with you. Y'all be cool. Come on, me boy. We still gonna make that poker game, man. Come on.
Let's go if you need anything.
Get out of here.
Come on.
All right, look at this.
Baby, baby, what we gonna do?
What do you mean?
I deserve that job.
I know.
I work hard.
I know.
Oh, Lord Jesus, what we gonna do?
What? You know what we gonna do. Now, I don't know why you sitting over there moaning like that. You know what we gonna do,
get you.
We gonna fall down on our knees, call on the name of the Lord, and he gonna help us and get back up on our feet again.
I'd rather get drunk. We gonna fall down
you
on our knees.
You wanna get drunk? Is that what you said?
We gonna fall on our knees.
Yes.
I lost my job.
Yes.
Call on the Lord.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
That's what. The Lord will make a way somehow. That's what we gonna do, baby.
Yeah, you're starting to feel it, huh?
Well, I want you to tell. I want you to do something.
Yeah.
When you go down to your secret closet,
where
it's just you and God.
See, that's your
I need
come
you,
on,
baby, to do me a favor.
What you want me to do?
Will you do
baby?
Something for your husband?
Oh, you know I will.
Will you do me a solid, baby?
Yes, I will.
I need you to do it for me.
Gotcha.
Don't fool me now.
I won't fool. Come on, baby.
I need you to do this for me, baby.
What you want?
Ask him a question.
I will.
Ask him why he took my damn job.
Henry, I don't believe you talking like that.
Edna.
How do you expect me to talk to God that way? What is wrong with him?
Ooh, hey, Edna.
How you doing, girl?
Hey, Edna.
What is wrong with Henry?
Girl,
I ain't got time for all that. I came here to fill you in on goings on around town, girl.
Wait a minute.
Have you and your mama had y'all's prayer meeting yet?
Girl.
Because I got showed up, got a whole bunch of stuff to pray about, girl.
Girl, wait a minute.
Because you heard about Wanda, didn't you?
No.
You know Wanda, she's up going with that robber.
Hennessy.
I told her that robber was no good.
Hennessy.
But did she listen? No, she didn't listen.
No, you ain't listening either.
You know what? Robert got busted. You know, they said that he was caught with Mrs. Jones. They say, he and Mrs. Jones got a thing going on.
Hennessy,
you know
I really
I mean.
Don't have time for that today.
And girl, when it seems like it rains, it wanna pour. Cause you know what, her little brother Freddie, you know little snotty nose Freddie, he used to hang out on the street, and then he used to mess with us when we was trying to do our jump rope and hopscotch and everything.
Girl, well you know he always had a problem with coke, and you know, he got on the dope thing.
Uh-huh. And now well, he ain't gotta worry about no dope, no coke or nothing else, baby. Cause you know what? Freddie is dead.
Hennessy, look.
That's what I said, girl. And why they got to let me go to the prison? They let me go to the prison.
Hennessy.
Baby, they had these lenses there. They was all buff and all fine.
Hennessy.
They had gold teeth.
Hennessy.
Oh.
Hennessy.
Ain't
nobody got time for that. You don't even know what I'm going through today.
Oh, do you know? Do you know who you young man that?
Girl,
this is Tennessee from Tennessee. And ain't no John Perkins gonna be walking on me, baby.
Wait a minute.
I see where you coming from.
Wait a minute, Hennessy. That wasn't it.
Sister,
I was trying to tell you.
To spend a little time with our sister, but it don't look like you got time for me.
Wait a minute, Hennessy.
Okay. So when you get your head on straight, I'll come back and inform you of the goings on. But until then,
and we're doing,
I'm going to go see me some Don Cornelius, because he is fine.
As far
as baby. And I'm gonna go see me some soul train.
Wait,
soul train! And I'll see you later, baby.
What, Hennessy, wait a minute. I was just trying to explain to you what was going on. Shoot.
Oh, wait.
Oh.
Ah! And the G.
Yes,
who was that thing running down the street like the hell was on fire?
Well, that was my friend, Hennessy. She's just a little upset.
Is that girl you went to school with, Hennessy?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
Oh, girl, she crazy. You know my mama was crazy, too.
Yeah, mama, that ain't
right. Yeah, she was.
Mama.
Now, look here.
What?
What's going on with you, girl?
Girl, nothing. What you doing here? I didn't have a... What you doing here?
What you mean, what am I doing here? Now, you know this was the morning for the 50 women in white. Hallelujah, breakfast.
forgot all about that thing, Mama. But wait a minute. Do y'all really get 50 women to dress up in white and shout hallelujah over some biscuits? Why? Girl, no. Ain't but two or three of us in Jesus. But we had a good time in the Lord, girl.
Now, how come you ain't going, Emma G?
Mama, I've had some mornings. And I just don't think I can make it. It's just been one thing after
another. Now, what's wrong with you, girl?
What's wrong?
Yeah, what's wrong with you?
Well, yeah, what's wrong?
I'm gonna tell you what's wrong.
Good Lord. Now, look at this here, man.
I went down to the apartment building looking for me an apartment. Remember this morning? I was feeling good. I was looking good.
All right.
And then we go. She can't find nowhere to live.
Yeah, I know that.
And guess what else, Mama?
What else? What else?
I ain't gonna tell you like this, Mama.
What?
But I ain't going to no 50 women in white hallelujah breakfast and I ain't standing. I'm tired. I'm sick of it. You do it.
Oh, no.
Now, you know what, Mama?
Energy.
I can't do this.
Why
this
not?
Is too much. In one morning? One morning?
Well, now look, Energy. Now, you know that ain't how I raised you. Just because some little things come up, you get a little trouble, that don't mean that you don't call on the Lord. And I taught you and your sister to call on the Lord when stuff is going wrong. And you know that.
Yeah, call on the Lord, Mama.
That's right, girl.
That's what you want us to do?
I want you to call on
Lord. Boy, Mama, I tell you what. You call on the Lord. How about that? How about you call on the Lord, Mama? And while you were calling on the Lord, why don't you tell the Lord, ask him a favor for us.
What was
it? Ask us why he took Henry's job.
Ooh, Jesus. What is going on in this family this morning? Lord, that Hennessy running out like she crazy? If there's something wrong with old man Thomas and all kind of madness is going on. Oh, what? Oh, Lord, now. Hello? Yeah. Yeah, no, I'm family. Old man Thomas, no, he ain't here.
You can give me the message, though.
Say what? He got to have a procedure. Say you're going to have to cut on him. Oh, Lord Jesus. Oh, my Lord. All right, I'll give him the message. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey, okay, bye-bye. Lord Jesus. Something happened to old man Thomas. Something done happened to old man Thomas. Now, I don't know what all is going on in this house. What's that, girl? What's that?
Who was that on the phone?
Oh, that was just a bill collector.
Oh.
I told her, I got rid of him. Ooh, I just don't know what to do with this family this morning. I mean, the child, she ain't got no place to live, and Jean, and she done act like she done went crazy, and Henry done lost his job. I think Anna done lost her faith. And that's really tough. Lord, what we gonna do? I know what we gotta do. We gonna have to pray about this thing. We gonna have to take this thing to the Lord in prayer. I don't know what I'm thinking about. Sometimes we can't figure it out, but God can. And so we go to him in prayer. Lord Jesus, this is your servant, Ellen May. And I'm coming to you right now. I'm coming to you right now on behalf of my family, Lord.
Help me.
Lord,
help me.
I need you to help me. Because I ain't got nobody else to call on, Lord Jesus.
Help me.
Father, God, you know what? I know you're King.
I know you will. I know you will.
Lord, you fight my battle if I just keep still. I know you can, Jesus.
I know you can.
I know you can, Lord.
I know you will.
I know you'll take care of this situation right now. Father, I know you sit high and you look low, so I'm calling out for you right now, Lord.
Help me.
Lord Jesus.
Help me.
See, I know can't nobody heal and deliver quite like you can, so I'm calling out right now, Jesus.
Help me.
Lord Jesus, hear my prayer.
You promised me.
See, you promised me in your word
that you would be,
that you would be everything that I need and more. So right now, Jesus, I'm calling out. I'm calling out to you. You're the only one I can call on. Help me, Lord. Jesus, Lord, have mercy. Right now, Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I come to you calling on behalf of my family. Father, somebody is in need of a healing, and you said you're the balm of Gilead. So right now, I ask that you heal in the name of Jesus. And somebody else, Father God, needs shelter. Father, you said you would be our shelter in a time of storm. You said you're our tabernacle and our dwelling place. And so I call on you right now. Father, we need a blessing in your name. Father God, you said that you would bless us. You are our El Shaddai, our Adonai. Father God, you said you'd be with us, even in trouble. And so we're asking you to be in our midst right now. Father, help us to remember this.
I know you can.
There is nothing too hard for God.
You will.
You said that you would fight our battles. You said that you would. Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's what this family needed. They needed some prayer. I done come at this place with you. Lord, I just thank you. I thank you. We know you're going to do it right now. And whoever else needed a blessing, God going to do it for you too. Hallelujah. We just thank you right now, Lord Jesus. Ooh, Lord. Oh, Lord. Somebody at the door. Anna, you want me to get there? Ooh, Jesus. Oh, Lord. Ooh. Ooh-wee. How you doing, Pastor Shona?
Hey, Miss LMA. How you doing?
Ooh, I'm doing all right. I was just in here praising the Lord.
Well, oh, that's what I like to hear. That look like you've been working out with some shape up something.
Oh, you know.
Yeah, and they working too.
Child, I've been trying to firm up a little bit here and there, you know. I do what I can. Oh, Lord, you what you?
That's my word, God. That's my sword, my sin, my word. I got to hit the word for.
Well, good Lord. Ooh-hoo. That's a big old word now. Now, what bring you by so early this morning? I thought you was going to the breakfast this morning.
Well, you know, that's my plan, but I heard a little bird in the wind told me some information. I came back here to see what the Guam's own was.
All right, then. Look who done showed up.
Yeah, I see. Oh, Mama, wait a minute, Mama. I'm so sorry. You know, I just kind of lost it a little bit. I lost it just a little bit.
That's all right.
Yeah, but Pastor Shona, good to see you.
Hey,
how you doing?
Praise God.
Oh, yeah, yeah. What made you out this morning?
Well, I tell you, I heard a voice in the wind. And I heard about Henry's promotion.
Oh,
so I thought it'd be my honor duty to come on back here and thank you and really congratulate him personally.
Well,
and let y'all know that I want to see the reflection of the new job in this week's past.
Thank you, Jesus.
New Cadillac.
Pretty
ring. Hey, I'm gonna say
Hey, Pastor Shona.
Ooh,
now, did you say pinky ring?
Yeah, I did. Little bear right there, little bear.
Well, anyway, that ain't funny. But I just want to say to you that that ain't quite work out the way we had planned. What? No, see, because actually this morning, we didn't get no promotion. Henry got fired.
I got to do some more revival, but I'm going to get you a ride. No, I was saying that God will provide. Yes, I will.
That's what you were saying.
Yes, God will provide. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. God will provide for him. He's going to make this thing work out for you.
That's right. That's what I said.
Well, what
are you
gonna do?
Well, don't work. I don't know about all of that, but you know what?
What's that?
I need to quit hearing you talking about pinky ring.
Okay, I ain't gonna talk about pinky ring. I'm gonna talk about the Cadillac.
You talking about Cadillac?
Yeah. So what y'all gonna do? I mean, how y'all gonna pay for all this?
What do you mean? What we gonna do?
Uh-oh.
What's all this commotion and noise in here? That's the show up.
Hey.
Oh look. Oh Lord, Pastor Shona, what happened, baby? Your mama dead? Oh,
I'm
that was so
sorry.
Oh, she was a good old man. If that check, Pastor, well, you see the way my bank account set up, I got checking and a saving it, and I can't with the checking is just Pastor, just hold the check to the beginning of the month, and I promise I'll make good on it.
Ain't nobody.
Just hold on for the check.
Nobody came on
for
it. I know.
What are you here for?
I just came out here to congratulate you on your new promotion.
Oh,
that's right.
That's it.
Oh, well, yeah, I'm sure you heard that didn't quite work out the way I planned it. Hey,
Father,
please.
Oh, Henry.
Woo!
It's all right.
Y'all do it.
It's all right.
Oh, Lord.
Is you all right?
Please.
You all right? I know we fired you this morning.
This morning? Baby, we was riding high, moving on up, dancing, and everything.
I know you.
I was going to get a job. I was looking good.
I know you were.
But now, I'm under pressure.
Yeah,
pressure.
Right.
I feel like Pastor Shona said, don't
you? Oh, Lord.
Henry.
So, aside from being broke, busted, disgusted, no job, unemployed, I'm doing all right.
It's going to be all right. It's going to work out.
Yeah, it's going to be all right.
Help him out, Shona.
I mean, I hated that you look like you got the coat on and everything, but You know, this is time right now where we got to exercise our faith.
That's right. That's
and trust this God.
That's right.
How God's going to work this thing out.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let me tell you something. See, look. God is up to something.
That's right.
And you just got to... You got to hold on, because
right.
You don't think you do this thing. Girl.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. That's what you got to do. Just hold on to God.
Hold on to it.
Amen, right?
Amen.
Hey, what is this anyway? Some kind of intervention? All y'all getting together talking about old Henry behind his back?
No.
Well, I don't need y'all talking about me. What I need is junk.
Wait a minute now, Henry. Pastor Sharma surely did come over here to wish you congratulations. He didn't know.
Well, as he was saying, congratulations are not necessary.
Oh, but... I beg to differ.
All right, now. Tell
it. Congratulations are in order. All right. Because there's trembling in the atmosphere.
Come on, Pastor.
And when God is up to something, that means he's about to move on your behalf.
All right, now.
And at the end of your story, you are going to be the recipient of one of God's blessings. So therefore,
congratulations, thank God! Hey! Thank God!
Oh! Hey!
That's what I'm talking
about!
Hey!
I want to tell you something. Can I just be real for a minute?
Go on.
I ain't really feeling the God thing right now. And you can see, he ain't been working out for me.
Hold on.
Now that's just going to be about enough of that kind of talk from you. Now you know that God is still God in this household. And you know that when things go wrong, we still get down and pray. You know the Lord know how to work things out. He's still Lord and Savior. He's still King of Kings. What you talking about? Don't you know what the Bible say?
Well, I know what the Bible say. I read this big old thing out. They got dogs, cats, cat
legs,
and everything else on the hill somewhere over the rainbow. I know. I read the Bible. I went to Sunday school one day.
There's a lot that ain't in there.
That's on the back page. That's on the back page.
Well, now. That ain't quite what it
that
say.
Ain't quite right. Pastor Sharma, you need to talk
that
to
that ain't quite what it you say. But what it do say is it don't matter what you're going through. It don't matter what problems you got. The Lord is still able to deliver you and bring you through and provide everything you need.
Say,
Mama, tell him. Lord,
right.
Give him
that's
one of them
right.
Messages.
That's
Lord,
right,
Lord.
Right,
wrong with
now, when you give your life over to the Lord, you got to be sold out for him.
That's
that
right.
Means you got to go all in. That means you got to know what you know, that you really know.
That's your God.
God's going to work it out
that's
for
you.
Now, I understand you might be tired of hearing folks tell you that God's going to make a way.
But is he waiting?
He's going to do
it. Yes, he is.
Yes,
he is. Oh, please. No, don't do that. Thank you.
Yeah,
please don't
say.
I get it. I get it, brother. Please don't
say. Okay. I'm getting things like this right here.
Ooh.
You ready? I'm getting things. Say that. Hey. I know that time to come.
I deserve that stuff.
And every now and then, things get a little too rough.
What are you doing, brother?
Things don't go the way you think they do. Life don't look the way you dreamed it would. There are reasons that we go through. I have a plan for me and for you. So when life starts to get you down, hold your head up and stand your ground.
Hey,
we're
going through.
All right. But he's going to die.
He's going to leave his world to you.
Praise the Lord. I don't care what you're going
to do.
Look, you got to practice what you're preaching. So have a little faith.
Have faith.
All right.
What we teach is always praise.
Henry, I know you heard it all before.
I hear it every time.
But how the Lord can know He won't give you more than you can bear.
just go to night and kiss on your chest. Now these are things that people say. That's how the Lord will surely make a way. Just remember that these words are true. You gotta make it personal between God and you. When you're going through,
you give your life to Him, and He has His hand on you.
He will not let you. You got to know that God will see you through.
Now listen,
I know you think I don't want some stuff, but Pastor Stone don't want some stuff. I done been talking back, I done been lying off. But you know what, when I go through a storm, I don't be praying to God. I take a praise break.
That's it.
I can give God the praise, I say,
come on,
thank you. Thank you.
You know, we're going to be there Sunday. Yeah, we're going to be there because I can't wait for Sunday.
That's right.
Oh,
that's
right. Pastor,
what? I was not playing about that check. Hold on to it, Pastor. Hold it to the end of the month. I tried to make good. And look at you. What?
I can't wait till Sunday morning.
You and Pastor Laverne be there by yourself. I ain't going
there. What's that
thing? I ain't going there.
Now, look here. You come in here all sourpuss and everything. You quit picking on that.
Today.
Yeah, you got a message, and I'm the one that took the phone call.
What you doing answering the phone over here anyway? What did they say?
They said you won't have the procedure. They told me about that procedure. They won't have to cut on you and everything.
That ain't your business, Ella Mae.
Well, now look, you won't be all right.
Well, I was a little scared, I'll tell you. But that ain't your business. Don't you say nothing to
well,
nobody.
Well, you better tell your family.
I ain't going to tell
them. Look, if they gonna have you, gonna have a procedure. You better let them know something about it. Oh, fool.
Ella Mae, I just received the spirit.
You did?
I want to apologize to you.
You gonna apologize to me?
Yeah, I was too mean the way I talked to you and all. That's wrong.
Well, yeah, you are kind of mean
to me. You know what?
What's that?
You one of the holiest women I know.
Say I am.
Yeah, when I see you, you know what you remind me of?
What I remind you of?
Jesus.
You know, Lord, that I tried to be a Christian.
Yes. You know, when Jesus was going, they was going over to Jerusalem to a big celebration.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
All the disciples and everybody was with him.
Yeah.
And you remind me of some of the folks that was with Jesus.
Well, one of the disciples?
No, it wasn't one of the disciples.
Well, Mary or Martha?
No, it wasn't Mary or Martha. Not one of them. It was.
Well, who was it?
I know, when we was that donkey, he rode off. When he went in there. Now get on up out of
you
my house.
You make me sick.
Get on up out of my
house. What you mean get up out of here? You old mean bugger.
Get
you ain't got to talk to nobody like that this morning. Trying to get to the church house and you up here clowning like that. Oh, Lord, let me choke.
Get on up.
I'm trying to leave you.
Let me go.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, Lord, it's two of them. I gotta go to the toilet.
Mm-hmm. I ain't got no man.
I don't.
Oh,
I live in this house with my sister and her husband.
Amen.
I'm pretty much down on my luck right now.
Oh,
I see.
So you feel like you're getting more than your old fashioned bad luck? Is that what it is?
Pastor, that's exactly what it is. I just want to be happy.
That's what you want?
That's what I want.
Well, I'm going to tell you what you look for. You're looking for happiness in the wrong place. You're looking for happiness in material things, for cars, men, business, and stuff like that. But you know what you need? How you want happiness when you can have joy? See, I'm talking about joy and get you through the middle of a storm. That joy is down on the inside. That kind of joy, the world can't give you, and the world can't give you. That kind of joy is a blessing of God.
Oh,
yeah.
Pastor, what love and joy.
That's why you get a man. Get out.
I'm just tired of going through thing after thing.
God. You're going to be all right.
I don't think so. I ain't got no place to stay.
Why is it always me? All the boys in me that has to go. Why does it hurt so bad? Why is my life so sad? Am I wrong? For wanting it better, I try so hard to be the way I should be. I search so far to find happiness that's missing for me. I know it's there.
I used to think the very same way. So I woke up one day and I knew that God was getting me ready for our weeping. Strength enough to run this race. So take your faith. See what I have for you right now. This too will pass. What the devil has for you won't last. If you believe, you can get your share of the love.
But I ain't trying to get
that
right now.
Of this love, it's gonna get better. Yes, it will.
Don't worry about it.
Did somebody say something about some problems?
Yeah.
Look
kind of problems you got, Cece?
None of your business, Hennessy.
See, what it was that we were talking about the housing market of today's society, and I believe that I have covered that sufficiently. Amen. You don't have to worry about that.
The housing market? Oh, I know all about the housing market around Easttown, Cece. Honey, I got investment property, baby. Because I'm Tennessee, from Tennessee, and baby, I got the key. But I don't think this key is gonna help you, Cece. And why is that? Because word on the street is, your credit is BAD.
No, Cece!
Hold on! Look, Hennessy, every time you come around, you got some foolishness stuff. What you need to do is mind your own business. Sit down, because I have to go to the church and get my biscuits. And if I don't get my biscuits, it's going to be a problem with you and I, okay? Now, sit down, act like you got some sense. Look, I know you're home. You stay home right here. Hey, Jesus, put some in your mouth and just sit down. I got to go. I'll see y'all. Look here. You need to be at church on
you
Sunday.
You need to be at church.
Be at church on Sunday.
Be there, because I'm going to wear my new dress. Woo. As I was saying, I don't believe you. What? You know you could have asked me about the properties and stuff here in Etown. Because I know all about it. And besides, I don't know why you're trying to act funny. You know I'm your girl, Cece. You are not my girl. You're my sister's girl, and you know can't nobody tell you nothing. Girl, you talk too much. I am offended. I don't tell everything. I can keep stuff. I mean, most stuff. You know what? Don't be hate, because that's my gift. You know, God give it to me to inform the community about the
Hennessy,
that's going around
tax, if you know what I mean. Hennessy, that's your problem right there, girl. You need to quit informing the community of the events and affairs that are going on around town. Girl, you know that's called gossip, and you're the queen of it. You need to stop.
You ain't got no investment properties, girl.
But I'm going to get some, though. Hennessy,
see how to shoot. I ain't got none. You gotta speak it, it starts with a
vision. Oh! You know you my girl, right?
Yeah.
Give me a hug. You know I love you.
Yeah. Now I gotta go give me some investment properties of my own. You feel me?
Yeah, girl.
I'm gonna go get
you
some.
You go get you some.
Go get you some, girl.
You said start with a vision.
Ooh. When she gonna get some new cookies? These cookies are stale. Show
love. Ooh. Hey, Hennessy. Hey, girl. Hey, girl. I thought I heard you, and look at you. Still eating. Every time I see you, girl, you're eating something. I'm amazed you ain't up to 1,000 pounds by now.
You know, I was having a little conversation with Lucy. But, you know, I'm a chick on the moon in the room. And I gotta eat whenever I can, girl. But you know what? Ain't nothing gonna touch this brick house if you know what.
You need to.
Yeah, what you talking about? You talking to Cece? What you talking to Sheila for?
Yeah, she got all kind of different little problems and everything. She want to know about the investment properties and everything. Because, you know, they call me the regular fear.
You?
Girl.
Yeah, girl.
Miss Donna, you. So, what you doing?
Anyway, the real reason why I came down was to ask if there was something I could do. Because when I came down earlier, I was just a little bit, insensitive, because I didn't know you had so many things going on with Henry that lost his job, your mama living, getting on your nerves, and Sheila living off of you and everything. Girl, I didn't know.
Well, you know what? You said you wanted to do something for me. What you could have done was got my sister up out of here before Henry stormed in here with his good news.
Yeah,
I can only deal with one problem at a time, Hennessy.
Girl, well, you know. You know, Henry, he's hard on the outside. But you know, dude, he's hard on the outside.
Something about my hearing.
Yeah, you better hush your mouth.
And she's all right. Her self-esteem is about right up there about that.
Up there.
And Miss Phil Donnie, her job, girl. She's gonna be all right. She's gonna get her some investment profit.
A lion?
What's she saying? Oh, nothing, girl.
Let's finish having our conversation. Well, thank you, Miss Donnie. I tell you. She's some mess, girl, living in here all day in here. Sometimes she worse than any kids you could know. Kids? Girl, you don't know nothing about no kids. What? It's it? What you talking about? What's wrong with you, girl? I know ain't nothing wrong with your kids, but you got some good kids.
Oh, yes, you do. Them boys, they do fine in school, I know that. And that teenager of yours, she's just a stand-up role model.
Well, them boys, they do all right, long as I keep them from that wayward crowd. But that stand-up young lady
here,
some lady down with some knuckle-headed boy,
so that girl's pregnant.
She's pregnant.
One pregnant.
Pregnant. Not one, not two, but 3 months pregnant. Girl, what am I going to do?
Oh, do they literally start pregnant?
I don't care.
No,
I don't care.
No.
I try to get a good man. I dress it up on Sunday. I try to look good and sing good. But I still can't get no man. But I done the best I can.
Yeah, wait a
minute. They used to call me Pearl, but now they call me Hennessy. Because as that girl was starting to feel crazy, you got to do it.
Your girl, no, I ain't got no, not that kind of drink. But Hennessy, you can't be tripping like this. And let me tell you something. You did right by that girl. All your kids. Yes, you did. You took them to church. Yes, she did. And you, all you do is teach them, teach them, teach them. And you know, bring them in, teach them right, what is right and what's wrong. But honey, at the end of it all, you got to remember that they have to take responsibility for themselves. They lay down, they got to get up with it. And you know what I'm talking about. So you're going to have to take this and lay it on off and give it to the Lord, honey, because this is not your fault. It's not. And you need to quit blaming yourself and quit making yourself feel so bad. And keep on looking good, girl, because you're doing that thing. Mm-hmm, that's right. You know, it ain't like it was when we was coming through. Hey, look, why can't we just do like the old days?
What you talking about, girl?
You know, can't we just beat them?
Beat them? Why? My mom give me them silver whoopings.
It works.
I can't do nothing.
Hey, y'all talking about? Talking about whooping on them kids.
Yeah.
They gonna start putting people in jail about messing with them, baby. Y'all better.
No, daddy. They gonna say, you need to take the child and put him in a corner and let him think.
Let him think.
How you doing, Deacon Thomas?
Hey, now, Seagrams.
What?
Alizé, whatever name
it's is. Hennessy.
Same.
About laying it on the altar, honey. Because that's what you got to do. You got to give it over. Give it up and let God handle it.
Yeah, I'm going to get on up out of here. Because, girl, you know,
I can't wait
till Sunday, girl.
All right, then. All right, call me, girl.
Wait a minute.
What?
Y'all got something y'all want to take to God. You ain't got to wait till Sunday. You know I'm chairman of the Deacon's Board. I got a red light. I can talk to God right now. Come on, play her. Call me, Lord. Lord, help me, Lord. Lord, help me. Come on, Lord. Where everybody at? Hold on a minute. Keep your panties on. I've been talking to God. Oh, Lord. Ooh, it take a lot of you when you pray. Hold on a minute. Ooh, good God Almighty. Ooh, Lord.
What?
This is the devil. Hold on, watch your foot.
What's wrong?
No, watch your foot. I don't want your foot to get messed up.
What you doing?
No, put the foot back there.
All right.
Hold your face up here for me.
What you
doing? Now, just get that out of the way.
What you?
Yeah, put your foot back.
What?
Hold your face up.
What?
You ready?
Yeah.
So these folks are fooling with me. I ain't got time to be fooling with these folks. They crazy. Coming all up in here.
Woo!
Good morning, Big Papa. How you doing this morning, honey?
Hey, look
at that new phone, honey.
Congregation,
and we're
ready
to
go.
We're
sure
we're
working
with.
Ooh.
this and they'll go run and tell everybody. And they'll all come to the church, want to see what we got going on. Then that's where you take over.
Oh, no, Deacon, I'm not going to have any parts left. See, I know, no, Deacon, no, 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 you got all wrong. You letting the world influence you?
Huh?
We supposed to be influencing the world.
I'm trying to help you.
No, Deacon, this is the place where we supposed to come fellowship and teach people about Christ. Come on, if we got to use gimmicks, then we might as well shut the door down.
Well, come on now.
Come on, no, 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 Deacon, no. What? Now, I'm not going to really stand for this. But we're not going to have it. Matter of fact, you're not even doing your job.
What you mean?
Well, I mean, that's your job.
I brought this from home because I was praying with this.
You can't even tell Jesus on this.
Jesus touched this phone.
He
talked to me through it. That's how come the cord came off, because he talked through it. That's too much power. That's power.
That's power. But I tell you what, it's about time.
Okay. Now, by what I was saying,
what?
If you change your mind,
I'm not.
Just give me a sign.
Fine.
And I got you. I got you back. Now, if the worshipers are starting to come in, it's almost over.
Yo, please.
But remember, hey, second lady. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Welcome. Come on in. Assembly of Faith Methodist Christian Temple of God of the Disciples, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, non-denominational church.
Deacon,
what, boy, what do you want? I am trying to lead these people in worship. Call you for one. Shut up, I'm trying. I want you to know that you are welcome.
Deacon,
what?
Deacon, get in
your way. Boy, come on, Deacon. Come on, come on.
Who, me? Oh, good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Good morning, everybody. Hey, I just wanted to stand here since you called me.
All right.
Excuse me. I just wanted to stand here and publicly say I'm sorry to my family for being an offspring to went through past the check. And I just want to say I'm sorry.
Okay, all
but
right.
But there's a song on my heart.
Oh, no, there ain't no song.
And I want to say,
no.
And I know I don't want no man.
No, no song, ain't no song. Give a hand if it takes a seat.
Did she have to say something?
Yes, sir.
Oh, Lord, be careful. Wear the light on you.
Oh, Lord.
Yes.
That's where. But look at God. We don't meet the cowboys.
Hey,
please.
That's all right.
All right. Well, Pastor.
Yes, right.
Well, I do these here announcements.
All right.
I need to say something to my church.
You need to talk in the microphone. We can't hear you, man. What you saying?
I said I need to say something to my church family.
Oh, Lord.
Can I do that now?
Go ahead, please, hear it. Don't hear it.
Okay. I just want to thank you, Pastor.
Oh.
I just wanted to come up and thank my church family. But the beautiful flowers and heard that they sent me last week when I died.
Well, that was my fault. She did look dead at Bible study, so we went ahead and set the flowers out.
Well, Pastor, what had happened was, see, I have diabetes.
You got what?
Diabetes.
You got little bitty.
Diabetes.
Diabetes?
Yes, that's what it is.
Okay, sure. She got the sugar. Okay,
yeah,
you got the sugar.
I got the sugar.
Okay.
And when your sugar is up high, you go to sleep and you sleep real hard.
Oh.
And you don't even know you're sleeping.
Oh.
Oh, get somebody get up. Hey!
Oh, come here.
That's it. Come on, announcements.
You're doing an announcement. You're making us miss the cowboys is what you're doing.
Well, I just wanted to thank God for the flower and the car.
All right.
You too, too.
Yeah.
I just want to ask you that. If I die at the beach, would y'all send me some flowers in the car?
Oh, no, no.
Freeze them.
We're going to freeze them.
Oh.
Freeze them.
Freeze them.
Come on, madam.
Now, okay, these are the announcements for the week. The senior choir will be having rehearsal every third Tuesday of every odd month.
I know.
Only,
you got to be on time for that. You
beginning next year sometime. Please be on time or you will not be able to.
Oh, Lord. Nobody gonna remember that.
That's pretty rich. Every Sunday
Lord Jesus.
It's all right. Come on, man. Come on.
Now, listen, dear pastor.
Come on, it's Wednesday.
The pastor has asked that if you are on the street, then you stuck in there.
Did she cuss?
He be sticking. Hold
on. Hey, y'all, bleep that out. Bleep that out.
I need to be on the stick and the stuck in.
Oh,
is coming up.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord.
Because you know how you to be.
What she mean?
We want to do our part.
You get hooked on time.
To show our pastor and the second lady our appreciation.
Yeah, ma'am.
She is a second lady.
Anyhow, we're asking each member to do their part.
All right.
And give a small donation.
Small donation.
Of $30.
$30. That ain't too bad. I can do that.
Read that again.
Oh, excuse me. Did him say $3,000? So we can really do something
special.
Yeah. And send the pastor and the second lady to Las Vegas.
To Las Vegas.
We want them to have enough money when they get there, so they can do a lot of games.
Yeah.
question. Yes, sir. Well,
Sonia!
The next month you are here will be dead of our wonderful pastor.
Yes, yes.
Live or Stephen. The pastor show enough. Let's receive him with a hearty amen.
Amen.
I didn't hear you say amen.
Amen.
Can you say it real? Don't say amen.
Amen.
Oh, that's what I'm talking
about.
Amen.
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 Amen. I come to you this morning.
Ooh, Lord.
Everybody.
Yeah.
And I want to ask the church a question.
All right, now.
The question is, why did you come?
Oh,
I mean, what did you really come
for? Would you come now, Chairman of the Deacon Board?
Now, the reason that I ask you this question is because of how you respond.
Well,
see, we have a trying week this
week.
And I'm a little concerned about how you all have responded to trouble in your life. See, I'm confused because when things are going good in your life,
Oh,
you can sing about Jesus. You shout about Jesus. Even testify about Jesus. Some of you got nerves you want to counsel about. But when trouble comes knocking at your door, you get spiritual amnesia. You forget that the same God that you were singing about, shouting about, talking about, can solve your problems. You know, I give the tithe of these Mary and Martha saints around. I heard your question. What is a Mary and Martha saint? I'm going to tell you. They change folk that hang around Jesus all the time. They know Jesus.
All right.
Love on Jesus.
Yeah.
Talk about Jesus. But as soon as something goes wrong with their life, they want to start blaming Jesus. When their brother died, Jesus had to be here. He could have left. Y'all got the same kind of conversation.
Come on.
Sister Hennessy.
Well.
Yeah. Jesus, if you showed up, I wouldn't go see. You can start questioning God. Asking God why you can't. But if I'm showing up and see all your God just take you when you don't have a heart.
Come on now.
But I want to know whether soldiers in God's honor are. You know, we need some soldiers like this in the church.
Come on now.
Something like him.
Come on.
Because he didn't even know. He wasn't even part of. Jeez, he was our enemy of Jesus. But I'm glad that he had the mind.
Come on.
You know the power of Jesus.
Yes, sir.
But if I can lack his faith, he knows Jesus. I ain't going to be the son of a
house.
But if you could just speak a
voice.
I know what my servant could be.
That's right.
I've asked you, where is your faith? Why can't we let people outside the church have more faith than we have?
Come on.
Everything is up. I don't really care what you're going through.
Right.
I know you have some problems.
That's right.
But whatever you're going through, is nothing compared to what Jesus went through on your behalf.
Yes, sir.
See, I know your situation looks weak.
Yes.
I know it looks dead.
Yes.
But God specializes in changing dead situations.
All right. Yes.
Just like He moved for Mary and Martha, He can move for you.
Yes.
You know, Jesus, I mean, He had. The death and the grave.
Come on, now.
What you talking about? They got tired of him bringing folk back to life. Tired of him healing people. So he hanged up on Jesus. And on that Friday night, friends that he had, people that he had helped turn their back on. But the Bible says,
come on,
that God so loved the world that he gave his only son. I got the news.
Come on.
See, the word means everybody, believers and non-believers.
Come on.
And I'm going to let you know that whatever your Friday night situation is, we serve a God that can defeat death.
Come on.
God that can defeat the grave.
Come on.
And God that can defeat the devil.
Yes.
And if God can do all that, he can change your situation.
Oh,
I want to tell that a Sunday morning is on the way. Friday night can happen.
Yes,
Sunday morning is on the way.
Oh,
I like the story because when people thought he had died,
situation was over. Yeah, I don't know what you're going through tonight. You might have a dead situation in your life.
Yeah.
You might be going through heartache, trouble, and pain. Burning. Oh, but the God that rolled up on Sunday morning with all power in his hand, he can change your situation. He can change your situation. Don't you know that because of me, I can face tomorrow. Because of me, all of my fears God.
When Sunday comes.
won't have to cry no
that was calling.
All right, then.
I see y'all. Y'all showing me dance. Where y'all be? Where y'all from?
Yeah, where was you?
Hey, Pastor, I'm gonna tell you something. You sure brought a word today.
Yes, sir.
You know, I can see how people can get all bogged down with the worries of the week, and they need a word on Sunday. Hey, Harry, lift him up again.
Yeah.
I know you.
Yeah.
That's your daddy.
Look, I'm looking for all my.
to you.
I'm Miss Mom, how you have. I know you lost your job. But I'm going to have you leave.
Thank you. There's the ladies. Survey that. Drew Hunt. Jessica Jackson. Meatball. Devontrell Dunbar. Bubba. Stanley Trice Jr. Our First Lady, Tinda Dunbar. Sister Maddie, Jerry Crane. Sheila, played by Brukel Bates. Tennessee from Tennessee. Angela Trice. Miss LMA. Michelle Jackson. Right. Edna, played by Lynn Farmer. Henry, Mr. E.J. Simmons. Pastor Sean Duff. John Johnson. Mr. Stanley C. Jackson, Sr. Yeah.